Hello everyone, today topic discuss a lymphatic system. So these are the new chapter. Previous class discuss the digestion and absorption and breathing and exchange of gases. So complete this lesson. So today a new lesson, body fluids and circulation. So circulatory system, like the first part, the lymphatic system. First one, a lymphatic system. First one, lymphatic system, one of the part of the lymphatic system. So the lymph is a part of the blood circulatory system. So lymphatic system is a part of the blood circulatory system. Lymphatic system is a part of the blood circulatory system. Next one, first one, a lymph. So lymphatic system is a open type of circulatory system. Open type of circulatory system. The lymphatic system is a open type of the circulatory system. Next one, the lymph is a colorless fluid. 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 Next one, it lacks. Lacks means absent. It lacks RBC platelets. RBC platelets. It lacks RBC platelets and large plasma proteins. Large plasma proteins. It contains more leukocytes. It contains more leukocytes. The lymphatic circulatory system is the open type of the circulatory system. So lymphatic system, circulatory system majorly presenting on the lymph. So the lymph is a colorless fluid. Lymph is a colorless fluid. Next one, it absent of the red blood cells, platelets, absent of the red blood cells and platelets and large plasma proteins. It's presenting on the more leukocytes. Leukocytes means white blood cells. The lymph is majorly formed in the plasma and lymphocytes. The lymph is majorly formed by the plasma and lymphocyte. It also presenting on the nutrients. Small amount of the nutrients. Next one, enzymes, hormones, etc. So presenting on the small amount of the nutrients, enzymes and hormones are presenting on the lymph. So lymph is a colorless fluid. Next one, it absent of the red blood cells, platelets. It presenting on the more leukocytes. A majorly lymph is formed by the plasma and lymphocytes. Next one, the formation of a lymph. Formation of a lymph. First one, the blood flow into the arteriolar capillaries. So the arteriolar capillaries the presenting on the blood hydrostatic pressure. So the blood flow into the arteriolar capillaries. In the ending of the arteriolar capillaries, presenting on the blood hydrostatic pressure. In this pressure, the filtration of the blood. This pressure helps from the filtration of the blood. The articular capillaries to the blood entering from the tissue space. These are entering from the tissue space. So these are the filtering of the articular capillaries to tissue space. Once these fluid entering into the tissue space, so these are called the extracellular fluid, ECF, extracellular fluid. Once revised, the blood flow into the arteriolar capillaries. Arterioles to arteriolar capillaries. The ending of the arteriolar capillaries, the presenting on the blood hydrostatic pressure. This blood hydrostatic pressure helps from the blood filtration from the arteriolar capillaries. The blood filtering from the capillaries to tissue space. Once filtering, that fluid is called the extracellular fluid. The filtering of the nutrients, plasma, small plasma proteins, they are the filtering from the blood capillaries to intracellular, intra-tissue space. So the except large plasma proteins. So the large plasma proteins are the does not filtering. So they are presenting on the blood capillaries. There is no filtration of the extra, the large plasma proteins. These are presenting on the blood capillaries. Only filtering from the plasma, water, nutrients, salts. They are the filtering from the arterial capillaries to cellular spaces, tissue spaces. Once the fluid is called the extracellular fluid. So the in this fluid presenting on the nutrients, gases are utilization of the tissue cells. Next one, the venular capillaries. The not filtering large plasma proteins are presenting on the venular capillaries. So they are the large plasma proteins. The large plasma proteins presenting on the venular capillaries. So these are the increasing of the colloidal osmotic pressure. So the large plasma proteins are the does not filtering. So they are flowing from the arterial capillaries to venular capillaries. These venular capillaries presenting on the large plasma proteins increasing of the colloidal osmotic pressure. So the these colloidal osmotic pressure, they absorption, they are absorption of the 85% of extracellular fluid entering from the venular capillaries. So these extracellular fluid entering from the venular capillaries. Once the venular capillaries are presenting on the large plasma proteins. The extracellular fluid entering from the tissue space to entering from the venular capillaries. Going to the blood vessels. So the remaining 15% of the extracellular fluid, in the tissue space are presenting on the only 15%, 85% move to the venular capillaries. The remaining 15% of extracellular fluid, they entering from the lymph capillaries. So the 85% of extracellular fluid going from the venular capillaries to the venules. Next one, remaining only 15% of extracellular fluid, 15% of extracellular fluid. That 15% of extracellular fluid, they entering from the lymph capillaries. They entering from the lymph capillaries. Once the fluid entering from the lymph capillaries, is called lymph. The extracellular fluid once entering from the lymph capillaries, so these are called the lymph. These are called the lymph. So these are the formation of the lymph. So the blood, the flowing from the arteriolar capillaries, and the ending of the arteriolar capillaries presenting on the hydrostatic pressure. This pressure helps from the filtration. The filtering fluid is called the extracellular fluid. So these are the absorption of the nutrients, gases. So the remaining, the large plasma producer, they does not filtration. So they are presenting on the venular capillaries. So they are increasing of the colloidal osmotic pressure. These pressure helps from the extracellular fluid as the absorption. 85% of extracellular fluid moving to the venular capillaries to venules. Remaining 15% of extracellular fluid, they entering from the lymph capillaries. Lymph capillaries. Once the fluid entering from the lymph capillaries is called the lymph. Once the extracellular fluid entering from the lymph capillaries is called the lymph. So the lymph capillaries are combined from the lymph vessels. Lymph capillaries. So lymph moving from the lymph vessels. Lymph vessels. A lymph vessels to lymph ducts. Lymph vessel to lymph ducts. Lymph ducts to jugular veins. Jugular veins. So they are the first one, a lymph capillaries. The lymph capillaries are combined from the lymph vessels. Lymph vessels are combined from the lymph ducts. The lymph ducts finally opens to the jugular veins. That jugular veins are connecting from the venular system. Venular system. So they are the lymph. So the lymphatic system is looks like a tree-like structure. So this looks like a tree-like structure. The lymphatic system is a looks like tree-like structure. Tree-like structure. Next one, the lymph vessels and the lymph ducts. Lymph capillaries and lymph ducts is same to vessels. Same to vessels. The lymph capillaries or lymph ducts is same to the vessel like structures. Vessels like structures. Next one, the lymph capillaries contain a walls. Lymph vessels contain walls. Contain walls. Lymph vessels contain a walls. Walls means like, so these are the lymphatic vessel or lymphatic duct. So these are presenting on the walls. So these are presenting on the walls. So these walls helps from the only one way of the blood circulation, only one way of the lymph circulation. So does not prevention of backward flow, only one way of the movement. Next one, the lymph vessels or lymph ducts contain a smooth muscles. Lymph vessels or lymph ducts contain a smooth muscles. Lymph vessels or lymph ducts contain a smooth muscles. That smooth muscles, they formation of the peristaltic movements. So they are causing from the peristaltic movements. They helps from the peristaltic movements. That peristaltic movements helps from the lymph flow from the abdominal part to neck region. They are moving from the abdominal region to neck region. So these are the lymph vessels and lymph ducts. సో దే ఆర్ ది లింపాటిక్ సిస్టమ్. లింపాటిక్ సిస్టమ్, ద లింపాటిక్ సిస్టమ్ మేజర్లీ దే ఫార్మ్డ్ బై ది లింప్ క్యాపిలరీస్, లింప్ వెజిల్స్, లింప్ డక్ట్స్. సో ద లింప్ వెజిల్స్ అండ్ లింప్ డక్ట్స్ ఆర్ ఈక్వల్ టు ది వెజిల్స్, వెజిల్స్. సో దే ఆర్ ది ఈక్వల్ టు వెజిల్స్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ దే ఆర్ ప్రజెంటింగ్ ఆన్ ది వాల్స్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్ ద వాల్స్ ఆఫ్ ది లింప్ వెజిల్స్ అండ్ డక్ట్స్ ప్రజెంటింగ్ ఆన్ ది స్మూత్ మజిల్స్. దట్ స్మూత్ మజిల్స్ ఆర్ హెల్ప్స్ ఫ్రమ్ ది పెరిస్టాల్టిక్ మూమెంట్స్. దట్ పెరిస్టాల్టిక్ మూమెంట్స్ ఆర్ ది మూమెంట్ ఆఫ్ ది లింప్ టువార్డ్స్ ది అబ్డామినల్ రీజియన్ టు ది లింపాటిక్ నెక్ రీజియన్స్. సో దే ఆర్ ది లింపాటిక్ సిస్టమ్, ద లింప్ ఫార్మేషన్. నెక్స్ట్ క్లాస్ ఆర్ డిస్కషన్ ఫ్రమ్ ది లింప్ డక్ట్స్.